Genetic testing of embryos is used for a number of different things, and we'll talk a little bit about the different forms of preimplantation genetic testing, or PGT, in just a moment. But in general, genetic testing of embryos is done at the early stage of development, when embryos are what we call blastocysts. At that stage, there are two distinct cell populations, the trophectoderm, which forms the placenta, and the inner cell mass, which forms the baby. What is done is about 5 to 8 cells out of several hundred cells are removed from the trophectoderm that eventually will form the placenta without harming the embryo's ability to create a child. And those cells are utilized for genetic testing for various purposes. In general, PGT is broken into 3 separate categories. There is PGT-A, or preimplantation genetic testing for aneuploidy. There is PGT-M, preimplantation genetic testing for monogenic diseases, and PGT-SR, preimplantation genetic testing for structural rearrangements. PGT-A is utilized to test for whether or not the embryo has the right number of whole chromosomes. So all of us have 46 chromosomes, and those chromosomes are created when the egg goes from a whole set of DNA to a half set, and the sperm does the same. They combine to create a new child. That process sometimes doesn't go correctly. There can be a tendency to throw out too many chromosomes or keep too many chromosomes. When that happens, there are 3 main outcomes that can occur. Number 1, the embryo never implants and creates a pregnancy, and that's actually the most common outcome. Number 2, the pregnancy implants and creates a pregnancy that ultimately, unfortunately, results in an early first trimester miscarriage. There are a couple of chromosome abnormalities which can result in ongoing pregnancies. For example, trisomy 21, also known as Down syndrome. So PGT-A tests for whether or not an embryo has the correct number of whole chromosomes within it. And that allows for a better chance that that embryo, when transferred to the uterus, will create a healthy child. Preimplantation genetic testing for monogenic diseases, or PGT-M, is a special type of genetic testing that includes PGT-A, but also looks for a specific genetic abnormality. These might be found on your expanded carrier screen, which is done as part of the workup. And that looks for genetic diseases that are inherited from the egg and the sperm. This would be like, for example, cystic fibrosis. So cystic fibrosis is caused by a genetic mutation in the DNA. And if both the egg and the sperm source carry a mutation for cystic fibrosis, there is a 1 in 4 chance of having a child affected by the disease. If we know what we are looking for, PGT-M is able to screen embryos and determine whether or not embryos are unaffected with the condition, whether or not they are carriers of the condition, just like the egg or the sperm source, or whether the embryo is affected by the genetic disease. That allows for us to select an embryo which is either a carrier or not affected and transfer that embryo into the uterus in the hopes of creating a child that is not only genetically normal with PGT-A, but is not affected by the single gene condition when utilizing PGT-M. Now, PGT-SR, or PGT for structural rearrangement, has to do with when the egg or the sperm source has the right amount of DNA, but that DNA is in an abnormal orientation. And now what happens is when the egg or the sperm source goes from a whole set of DNA to a half set of DNA to combine with the other, that ends up resulting in a much higher likelihood of a genetic imbalance in the embryo. That, with PGT-SR, ensures that the embryo has the right amount of DNA so that when transferred, we can have it be either a genetically normal embryo or a genetically balanced embryo, just like the egg or sperm source would have been. As part of PGT-A, we test for all of the chromosomes. As part of that information, we obtain information about the sex chromosomes, the X and the Y. So XX is female, XY is male. There are several different medical reasons which might cause an individual or a clinician to select for one gender or the other. One of the potential causes is an X-linked genetic mutation. And in that case, we may select for female embryos over male embryos. Some of them might be a Y-linked genetic mutation, in which case we may end up choosing one embryo over the other. One of the things that we see with PGT-A is that we do get information about the genders of the embryos. This information is part of the patient's record, and it is given to the patient to do with what they choose. And so by doing so, they may end up deciding to transfer one gender over another.